You know, actually, and that's a terrible thing to realize, actually, we have no love. We have sentiment. We have emotionality, sensuality, sexuality. We have remembrances of something which we have thought as love. But actually, brutally, we have no love. Because to have love means no violence, no fear. If there is love, there is peace. Because you would educate your children not to be nationalists, not to have only a technical job and look after his own petty little affairs. You would have no nationality. There would be no divisions of religions. If you love, but as these things actually exist, not theoretically, exist brutally in this ugly world, it shows that you have no love. If the mother really loved her child, do you think the world would be like this? So we have not that love. But you must have it. If you don't have it, you cannot have virtue, you cannot be orderly, you cannot live with passion. And there is no time. You can't say, well, I can't live without love because I've lived without love. For 2 million years, I've lived another 2 million years without love. That means perpetual sorrow for the next 2 million years. So what will you do? If you say, please tell me what to do, then you are missing the bus entirely. But if you saw the importance, the immensity, the urgency of that question. Not tomorrow, not next day or next hour, but see it now while you are sitting. Admittance of time is the greatest sorrow. As sorrow and love cannot be resolved, or love cannot exist through time. What is the state of your mind that has put this question? If you put that question with that alacrity, with that urgency, with that potency, then what takes place in the mind?